stream, as far as I'm aware.
Okay, our audio is on. People should hear us. Let us know in the chat if you can hear voices. Creepy voices.
The voices of the Monster Hunt.
Monstrous voices. Okay. How's it looking? Noise. We got noise. Let's see. Just looking at a screen. That's dedication. Cool, cool. We got you guys engaged. Alrighty. They said yep. So I guess that's a voice. Voices. Bonnie Moon. Thank you. That's a Bonnie M, actually. Alrighty. Let's get this show on the road. Let's take this off. Let me see here. What's going on? Okay, right there. Okay, let's get the music going. Very quietly.
We are kind of late today.
And let's get my cam on. There we go. Still waking up here. And let's show off our Discord. There we go. Beautiful. Everything's going smooth, I think.
We've got a penguin in the YouTube.
Alrighty. Welcome, everybody, to the Monster Cast, the most monstrous podcast on the internet, on the internets. This is the Monster Cast of number 15, where we're going to be discussing this, basically our Christmas special or end of the year special. That's why we're doing it on YouTube. If you guys want to see the show, we do these chats every week, Saturdays at 2 p.m. Mountain Standard Time. Over on Twitch, the links are everywhere. They're right here in the description. If you want to join in, then you can join our Discord to do so. That's where our speakers are going to be from or in. That's where we're all at right now, is on Discord. So today we'll be talking about Christmas monsters and maybe reflecting a little bit on our favorite moments thus far in these monster casts, Voices of the Monsterhood. We started these in, let's see, I don't remember which month. It was this summer sometime, if anybody can recall exactly. But I think, we've been going on, well, with the voices, we've been going on for maybe 3 months straight or something. So welcome, everybody. We will be looking at your comments over in the YouTube live chat. So, let us begin. As usual, I'm Monster Master Arthur, and we are joined today by Dogdanza. Go ahead.
Dogdanza, hello. Yes.
And Gargamel Gold.
Hello, everyone.
And Chris Chu.
I exist. Glutenabin. And I'm eating a tangerine.
Z.
I heard tambourine. It's just me.
And that's everybody beautifully introducing themselves. And then in the text chat over on Discord, we have Creative Equinox. We have Sad Donde. Or Donde, once he's happy again. And TMH Piccolo, who just gained his rank in our Discord here. Alrighty, so let's start talking about monsters here. Let's start with Gargamel. Gargamel, what Christmas monster did you want to mention on today's show?
Actually, there's three of them I want to mention, but I'll just mention each of them in passing. Sort of Santa, Krampus, and, oh yeah, the Grinch.
Nice.
Well, those are the most well-known.
Yeah.
Alrighty.
Sorry. I'm sorry if anyone's really upset. You can do some cookies.
You're good here. Go ahead and get started.
Then just broaden out.
There are some other ones. You can just look them up, Z. Look up Christmas monsters.
Googling Christmas monsters.
Yeah. Oh, Oh, it looks like someone else just arrived.
If you want to choose a favorite one from the list, Gargamel Gold, go ahead and cover that one.
I would have to talk about Krampus.
Okay, good start.
Because Krampus is like so unusual for like Christmas that you don't, you know, think of something, anything like remotely malevolent like a Krampus. Yet he does sort of have a good side because he exists in like to punish, you know, naughty children, although I'm not really sure like beating them or dragging them off to hell is like, maybe it's not okay because like that's kind of cruel, unusual punishment.
That's a little bit cruel.
It He's sounds like old Nick from Team Fortress 2. Oh, right.
What can you tell us about his origins, Gargamel?
I don't know too much about his origins. There are different versions of him. He's primarily like Germanic. I remember him like being like from Germany. He's like, at least initially, in Eastern European countries, he's like the demon of Christmas. He exists, like, he's sort of like a mixture between, like, he looks sort of like a mixture of Santa and, like, Satan with, like, goat stuff. And he's like, he comes, like, to punish the naughty children. Like, one version of the story of Santa Claus, in, like, some versions, he's, like, working with Santa Claus, and Santa only gives children coal. Not as a punishment, but to let Krampus know which children, you know, need to be punished. So Krampus will go to the kids with the coal.
Interesting.
And in some traditions, you get kids get like a golden stick who have been good. And the kids that have this the golden stick, Krampus knows to avoid them instead of punishing them.
Okay.
And they get some extra cash.
I'd like a literal golden stick.
I'm going to hold onto my staff of light tonight.
Have you seen
any... Yeah, I don't think you have to worry, Zeech. You're a Necron, not a child.
Yeah.
Yes, but these Christmas monsters are insidious.
Have you seen any movies about Krampus? Or with Krampus in them?
Yeah,
I've seen it.
Yeah, there's one movie. I can't remember what year it was from. I also just watched a review of it on YouTube.
Mm-hmm.
It's fairly recent.
I think it's only 2 years old, if that much.
It's one of the few Christmas horror movies where Krampus comes to town because this
one boy
made
a
wish for the holidays like end or something like that. And then Krampus begins killing off his family in the neighborhood like one by one.
Well, that's a delightful story, isn't it?
I think he killed everybody in the neighborhood, but he captured the family, if I'm not mistaken.
No, he kills everyone in the neighborhood and kills the family. But then, if you want a spoiler, I can give you where the end.
I saw they were in a light globe. Sorry if they're spoilers. Anybody that didn't see the movie.
Yeah, the kid basically begs Krampus to like take him instead of his like the last person he killed, and then he like kills that person and he falls again to hell and he brings everyone back, so it's like it seems like everything's going back to normal.
Okay.
And it zooms out.
Krampus is watching over them.
Alrighty. Well,
they're just in a snow globe.
Good start. Hooves and horns. Krampus. Let's see. Do you know the further back origins of Krampus there, Gargamel?
No, I don't. Except I know some societies have a special Krampus night.
Mm-hmm.
I really haven't looked it up, though. You can look that up. It's I remember reading about it and hearing about it recently.
Okay.
That's the demon part. Krampus, nice. The old stories that I know of is that Krampus would go and he would give presents to the good kids, but then instead of elves, he had like demons that would capture the kids, the bad kids, and drag them off.
Okay.
That's the version I know, anyways.
Now, Gargamel, do you have any memorable moments from the Monster Cast? Any favorite moments you would like to shout out?
I don't really have the best memories, but I do have one. I remember how I mentioned my, when the Silliest Monsters one, when I mentioned my Fluffies how Z thought they were so annoying, he wanted to, like, throw them to, like, the worst monster, one of the worst monsters in the 40K universe.
Eldar?
No. No, one that's, lot less family friendly.
Z, we do not talk about the space elves here. Also, they're not monsters, they're just stupid. So yes, Aradril, you heard me. You heard what I said.
Wow.
Alrighty.
Well, every faction in Warhammer 40K is kind of monstrous in its own unique, special, and disturbing way.
Yeah, in a good disturbing way.
The only thing monstrous about the orcs is they're monstrously hype.
Before I should get back to the holidays and get off of, like,
alrighty.
So, fantasy sci-fi.
Thank you for sharing, Gargamel. I'm gonna cut it to that one monster. If we have a lot more time or something, or some dead space, you can shoot in another one there. But let's go to.
If you're still here.
Let's go to Doug Danza and. What say you, Doug Danza? What monster would you like to cover? What Christmas monster? Or, remember, guys, this is the time of the year kind of monster. So it's winter solstice, really, mostly. And then we have the holidays from different religions that fall into here. So it's anything related, even to, you know, the winter season. Sorry, go ahead.
Yeah, there's only one monster, because most of the monsters I saw were just ripoffs of Santa with a knife that would kill kids. Like, I wouldn't even mention them. It's unoriginal. The only monster I found, aside from Krampus, is, I hope I'm pronouncing this right, Tomte. Mm. Basically, it's a fairy sprite. It's an old man the size of a small child. Basically, it would do the whole year round. It would care for animals on a vegetables on a farm. But then if you don't put a bowl of certain porridge and butter out for it at Christmas morning, it would basically kill all the animals on the farm, the inhabitants of the farm, and destroy all the crops.
Well, at least it would not, like, kill the family on the farm.
Well, it seems like to be the embodiment of starvation. Because if you could put a bowl of, what was it called?
Bowl of porridge.
Porridge to a gnome in the in the attic. I think with butter. I think you have enough food to survive the winter.
Pretty much.
Yeah, and you. And here in the U.S., it might not be that much of a threat because we have so much food that the family could basically just go to the grocery store and say, you know.
Yes, but he kills the animals, the plants, and the family.
He kills the family as well?
I said the family.
He's a pretty powerful little guy. Although if you do please him and you keep your farm well and clean and your animals fed, then he will actually protect the farm or something like so, right?
Yeah, he will. He'll protect the farm, he'll take good care of the animals. What I would like to know is, how do you know if he's there? Because it's not really, he doesn't make himself known.
Mm.
It's just, you have good fortune. So how do you know you're not just...
Well, I like the point of that. Animals probably. I like that you don't know that he's there. So you do it out of kind of good consciousness rather than fear. And that's how things should be done. Things should be done out of good rather than, well, fear or being overpowered by something, right? So...
Well, it sounds like even if you did know it was there, if you're doing it to please the thing because you're afraid it's going to hurt you, that is kind of out of feel.
Yeah.
Right.
But
so,
it has to be a certain type of porridge. It's not just your average, like, wheat porridge. I don't remember what porridge it is, but it's a very specific.
True. So you do have to serve them in a sense, too.
Sorry, what else?
Right, so you do have to serve him in a sense, too. So I guess he'll know he's there if the porridge is eaten or taken.
At least then you know if you have a fairy on your side, helping you with the farm.
Yeah.
If not, you wasted a bowl of porridge and butter.
Yeah, not too big of a deal. What part of the world does this originate from again?
I think it's like in Scotland or something. I'm gonna lie if I say I know. So I don't know.
Okay, right. It's definitely Europe. All right. Well, thank you, Dog Danza. Tell me what your favorite moments or memorable moments are of the Monster Cast thus far.
Favorite moment. When we were talking about, like, it was the Nightmares one from last time was one of my favorites, and the one I made the Yandere stuff, and I accidentally said that Japanese people aren't human. You guys remember that?
Kinda now.
Those are my favorite moments. I see zero members.
Can you repeat what happened?
You Arthur asked me, we were talking about this girl I knew that she was a real life yandere that made like deals of ghosts and could see ghosts.
Mm-hmm.
And then you asked me, is this girl human? Is this girl Asian? And I said, no, she's human.
That was great. I almost forgot about that. That was a great moment. That was one of the best laughs I've had on here.
That is 100% my favorite moment. Embarrassing, but it was my favorite.
It worked. It really worked. And I'm glad you get it. Let me see here. That nightmare or the dreams monsters episode talk that we did. And guys, if you missed that, that's over on Twitch. We have all the monster casts on there that aren't on YouTube permanently up there. So you can always watch them. You don't even have to have an account on Twitch. You just click on a link and you can check them out. But I like that one.
Oh, seriously?
Yeah. You don't have to join Twitch to watch the videos.
Why have I not heard of this?
There you go.
You can watch video. It's like YouTube. You can watch like YouTube. Videos on YouTube without having an account. You just can't, you know, post your own videos or leave comments.
Oh, bloody damn it, man.
Oh, I suddenly realized something. If can we bring mention to the Nightmare Before Christmas for monsters due to the fact, is that a Halloween or Christmas movie?
That's a good question.
I would say
it could be considered a Christmas movie, definitely.
I would say it's
definitely
both.
A Christmas movie.
Which one?
I think that's the monsters we've... Nightmare Before Christmas.
Oh, sure.
I think those are the monsters we've talked about the most on this, like, podcast.
Yeah, most of them are like there's like vampires, werewolves,
witches,
zombies. The boogeyman.
By the way, in the chat, let us know how our volumes are. If it's a little bit low, you might have to turn up your speakers. I tried to balance everything out here. The interesting thing about that dreams episode we had, though, was during that episode, I remember I was going to meet my friend in real life here later on. And we did talk with you guys, and Super OCD brought up the whole sleep paralysis and seeing something weird there. And I was driving around with my friend later on that day, and he had no idea about the Monster Cast or that we talked about that. And he just brought up his own sleep paralysis episode out of the blue. So that was pretty cool. And it was kind of weird because while we were chatting, I kind of imagined that he's going to talk about something like that later on in the day. So a little bit of a premonition, but it did happen.
Is that cool or creepy?
Depends. At this point in my life, it's pretty cool. It's acceptable. It's nice. He didn't experience any weird visions or anything, but he did experience sleep paralysis. So he wanted to call his girlfriend and he couldn't, and he was just kind of stuck there. It's a pretty interesting phenomenon. Anyway, thank you, Dog Danza, for sharing that and for reminding me of that great comment you made. Let's move on to... Or maybe I'll go now. So I'll go about in the middle of the voice chatters. So yeah, I'll take this spot to talk about the monster I wanted to mention, and that one is Lepaludi, and that's why I wanted to get a translation here in Swedish, but we don't have anybody from Sweden, I think, in our thing here. If somebody in the comments, pay attention. If you are Swedish or you understand the Swedish language, heads up. So my monster is
Lepaludi. You can put in the Google Translate, Arthur.
Yeah, but I don't have lyrics. So
better than nothing.
Yeah.
Siri, what does la 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 mean?
So let me pull up.
Svenska.
Lepaludi.
And now I cannot help but think of Dota.
So here's a picture of Lepaludi.
I'm so lost.
This is Icelandic lore. First of all, the main monster here is Grilla. And Grilla, I think I mentioned her in my top Christmas monsters video I did last year. She's this main troll monster. She's the mother of the Yuletide children, the Yuletide boys, which are these great troublemakers. She also owns a pet, a big black cat that eats people, children. She lives in a cave, and she lives with her husband, second or third, depending on which lore you read, whose name is Lepaludi. And there's nothing really special about him other than he's kind of a trollish husband, literally troll. She's more ugly than him, so she's really the shout out here. But I did want to shout him out because one of my favorite new, I'd say Christmas songs, but I don't even see it as Christmas song, but monster songs, is Lepaludi, is about him. And I'll play a segment of that song here, if you can listen up. Let's see. Oh yeah, and this is all streamed, so there you go.
Can't hear
it either. That's only if you're watching us on the live stream, sorry. I will put the link in Discord. Okay, so for the Swedish folks out there, I believe this is in Swedish. If somebody can please translate this song for me, or just let me know what this song is exactly about. And there's different versions of it, and it's a pretty nice song. It's got that old, nice, warm feeling to it. So that's my shout out to Lepaludi. Any questions? And again, there's nothing too special on quick notice that I noticed about him, other than he just represents that stereotypical kind of lazy husband, sits in the cave and probably just watches World of Monsters all day on YouTube.
It's not like we should characterize our fans and followers.
Yeah, good point. You don't want to make them angry at us and, you know, storm away.
So I guess mainly I wanted to shout him out because
that's worse than what I said.
The bigger story here is Grilla, so that's my like secondary shout out, I guess. But I just wanted to shed some darkness on our friend Lepaludi, since there is a whole song after him. Now I know that Chris, you're over there in Europe.
Or rather, my tomb lies somewhere underneath the Danish lands.
True.
I mean,
so
I'm still hiding on a Viking helmet or something.
Have either of you heard of this being or tales of it?
No, I haven't.
Well, the Swedes are a bit of a lost people. Z may have heard of it.
I mean, my knowledge about local folklore is limited to fairy tales and what's called folk tale and the advent. And such things about, like, why the ocean is so salty due to a churn that apparently churns out salt at the bottom of the ocean. Some mysterious reason.
It's because of sad sharks who cry. They don't want to give you hugs, the people here.
I don't have to tell
sad
you.
Sad sharks. Nobody loves them. Nobody wants to give them a hug.
Because of all the internet cables. Alrighty, well. And I forgot to mention in our chat, somebody mentioned we should do a monster ASMR. That's pretty funny.
What is an ASMR?
ASMR is that whole new thing where people, or there's like a YouTuber or streamer, and they have a great little microphone system, and they just make sounds into it. And people just sit there and listen to those sounds because they're so crisp and clear, and it's like this meditative thing. So, yeah.
What is with the new
generation? So, are we going to do the Hooked on a Feeling one for the first hour?
Why did you have to say that, Z?
I'm still believing.
We had a good thing going here. You're in love with See, you got Gargamel going.
Gargamel, chill. The party has not started yet.
All right, guys. So my
Monster Cast.
My favorite moments here in the Monster Cast. First of all, one of the recent ones, which was the episode we did on SCP monsters, which some of us didn't know much about.
So
but
sad I missed that one.
Yeah, that was an interesting one. So what happened there that I really enjoyed is at the end we did the whole looking up an SCP that was your number, because there's like thousands of SCPs. So like I looked up 1983 for your age, for your birth date. So everybody looked up theirs, and everybody had a different one, and somehow coherently, it all collaborated into a crazy party. And Gargamel had the shower.
Yeah, mine was a shower.
Yeah.
I'm going to check mine out now.
We had a host, we had a house, we had Z bringing in people. It was pretty funny little thing. Yeah. The other things that stuck out for me, that was the SCP episode. If you guys are a fan of SCPs, do check that one out. Or if you don't know what they are. I also enjoyed the early on Monster Cast where I first got to know you guys. Particularly when first Chris, because you were one of the first, and Z, you guys got on here and I actually got to put a voice with the people, you know, with the Monsterites of the channel. That, you know, that's always going to be memorable for me.
Oh, how nice. I still remember most certainly that one time where I somehow started asking about if there was any female watchers out there that eventually should have need of a nice personality, such as myself.
We're going to have a moment with Z here shortly. A little bit later. Looking for metallic women for Z. So, and that's a
metallic range of above 22 and to 65 million years old.
Here's the meme for Z.
Bloody hell.
So, yeah, and Dog Danzo's comment where I asked him if she's Asian and he said, no, she's human because he misheard me. That was one of my best laughs on here. So there's a few other ones I wanted to mention. I guess I'll mention them later. I'll let you guys go ahead. And let's move on to Chris Cho.
This is a wee bit awkward because we don't really have Christmas monsters here. So I'm not aware. The closest thing that would count as a Christmas or / festivity monster would be Baba Yaga, and I've talked about her at length already numerous times.
I can now not help but think of what's it called, that song from Bartok, The Magnificent.
Also, the
intro song.
That who drew that? Dante, did you draw that?
Let's see the drawing. Pretty awesome drawing. Arthur, I require female necromancer.
Are you laughing?
No, he's crying.
I'm missing some.
That is nice. That is very nice. Well done, Dante. Let's give him some watermelons, guys. Oh, yeah.
I look like a fucking goblin.
Yeah, you do.
Z, in all fairness, you are of Asian descent.
Trollish
are you
Necron.
Saying we are not human.
How many people?
I'm just kidding.
Answer.
What on earth? D, do you want to tell us something here? What on earth? No.
What off earth am I? Yes, that's a good question.
How many of you in the chat would guess that Z is of Asian origin? Let's see if anybody comments.
It's way too easy. I have said that many times. The thing is, what Asian country?
So, okay, back to...
Almost likely.
Back to Doug, back to Chris, sorry. Chris, why do you bring up Baba Yaga as your Christmas time or Yuletide or winter solstice?
That's in my here neck of the woods, we don't really have a Christmas monster. Any bad deeds happening around this time are usually addressed to warlocks and someone trying to mischievously do something, like a person, you could say, and being the chief OG witch around, normally she gets the spotlight. And trying to get in the middle of all the festivities to ruin everything for everyone, mm-hmm. that kind of thing.
Okay, alright. So she ruins Strange. The party or kind of starts the party for us. Baba Yaga, kind of the lead, the greatest of the witches out there. Kind of the boss witch. If you're going to fight witches all day, she's going to be the final boss, basically.
Yeah, the witches are not very fond of her. They'd actually help you fight her.
Oh. Because
they want to take all her stuff.
Nice. That makes sense, actually.
Okay, so whose side is a better side to join?
She's got a...
The one who crashes the parties and has a lot of stuff, or the one that steals stuff and want to kill you afterwards? Hmm. Who's the better person to join?
Well, either way, I mean, if you join the witches, you'll get some cool stuff. If you beat Baba Yaga, if you befriend her, then maybe she'll share her cool old charms and such with you and spells.
I mean, my brain is just saying that witches are not the most sharing of people, so you might help them and they'll stab you right in the back.
So in the comments we have, and I'm going to bring this question up a little bit later after everybody's done, get everybody to participate on this question. Let's see. Jaden in the comments says, do more videos on werewolves. I think a lot of people would like to see that. Let's see. You should deserve. I should deserve more subscribers? I should deserve. What does that mean? I want them. But she also says...
He thinks you deserve more subscribers, I think, also.
Yeah, yeah. She just missaid that. And he or she also said, do you do reading your comments videos? I think they mean, do you read the comments on the videos? And yes, I read...
I can remember that video. You remember that video made with the real-life monsters where you did, like, the goblin shark and the dinosaurs? I think she means, like, do you do comment video?
Oh,
I mean, we should have some compilations of you reacting.
Thanks
to
for clarifying that. I do do comments great. Or videos on reading your comments live. I have done those a couple times. I used to do that on Twitch. So on here, I'm not sure. We'll see. We'll see in the future. But I do read all comments. And you guys know I read your comment because I click on that love button. That means I read it. And I approved of it. I liked it. If I don't like your comment or disagree, then I just don't click the love button. But I read all of them. And also, Tom Matrick, welcome. Awesome that you're watching us. He's over in the comments, too. He's got a cool channel. We've been watching each other for a long time. He does actually magic tricks, but he talks a little deeper on things, too, which I appreciate. So, yeah, shout out to Tom. Alrighty. And... Okay, I think that's it. So, Chris Chu.
Before you go.
Sure.
Yes.
Z, I missed what you said when we were talking about the comments. What did you say?
I don't know.
Arthur okay, said my name.
Okay.
Cut out.
Chris, tell me.
No, but Z.
Thank you, Skittles, man. Chris, tell us your favorite moments of the Monster Cast, Voices of the Monsterhood here that you remember.
Well, overall, I adore all of these, every moment of the Monster Cast is there. It's great to just hang out with you guys and the people watching. I had to pick a favorite moment, though. Which one was it? I can't recall... There was one that made us laugh a lot. Like, everyone was present.
There has been a lot of those.
Yeah.
Actually, no, I think it's the same one where you made the Asians / humans comment, Arthur. That was hilarious.
For sure.
Everyone here knows that Asians are not humans. They are the superior species.
Yes, I agree 100%.
Jaden is a guy. Sorry about that, Jaden.
Chris Chu, of course, but you know, we might want to be a little careful with anything dealing with, you know, race, because there is some, you know, anything that could be interpreted as having a racist connotation is like problematic. Yeah.
No, it's all good. He's kidding.
I know he's kidding. It just,
but there are some people that are just oversensitive.
Yeah. That's true.
Yeah, and sometimes when it involves racism, actually it does have somewhat of a justification, because there are some people, for example, that, you know, have really suffered, you know, a lot in history because of it. So probably not the best thing to constantly bring up.
Alrighty. Okay. Also, in our text over on Discord, Creative Equinox, let us know your favorite moment in the Monster Cast that you recall, and also your monster that you would like to shout out here. Your Christmas or winter solstice type monster. With that, we'll move on to anything else that you wanted to say, Chris, by the way?
No, I'm all set.
Okay, so let's go to Z, our last voice here.
Let's see, what is it that I remember the most? Most clearly and most vividly. I think I did mention the one time I tried to court a human female into partnership, but how did that work?
You did the dance and everything.
Of course, would be the other one with me having a heartfelt moment. I don't remember what it was I was talking about, but...
Right. Moments with Z. We also have moments with Super OCD, who's not here today.
Feel kind of bad.
Yeah, and Victor's not here either. I was expecting him.
Expecting who?
Who's that?
Victor, he's been here lately in the voices too. Okay, Z, so what monster did you want to cover today, Z?
Well, I wanted to cover the Grinch, but I'm not sure that he just classifies as grumpy individual, nevertheless.
Oh, the Grinch is quite perfect. He was my first...
Well, he is a monster.
He is a monster. And he's very Christmas related.
He is a mutated deviation from the norm, and it will not be tolerated unless it can be exploited.
So go ahead, Z. What do you want to say about him?
Well, the Grinch is one of these beautiful, beautiful simplified moments that, characters that has been modified to suit a narrative, so to speak. But it's a beautiful narrative. It's about Christmas and feeling good and. Realizing the true meaning of Christmas. I think that's a card from Cards Against Humanity, but you know.
Yes.
The thing is that the Grinch just appeals to all those that cannot see the joys and the pleasantries in Christmas, and nevertheless, understand it, so to speak. But it also embodies a beautiful, beautiful, what's it called? A side of Christmas that is characterized in a way that does these people will never accept Christmas, are people that would never be able to. But when they look past all the material things and look past all of the limiting, isolationist loneliness, those. Their heart will grow 3 times and will probably suffer a heart attack.
And to kill them instantly.
Let me just say...
Did I mention that Jim Carrey is absolutely genius?
Yes, thank you.
Why?
Let me just say... To those people in the chat that are wondering what's going on, that was a moment with Z that you just experienced.
I feel like that drawing this much attention to me is going to end up damning myself in the end.
Well, maybe you'll get a girlfriend. A few million years old.
Ah, yeah, you know, you can never get too old to have fun.
So, yeah, thank you, Z. The first video, the first episode I've ever done, and I only have two of them, on the silliest creature out there. No, that was the second one, sorry. Was on the Grinch. And when I was editing that video, I was, you know, looking particularly close on the Grinch movies and the Jim Carrey one. And I don't know why, I don't think there's a reason for the new one that's coming out in the theaters. There was really no need for it, but cool, it's another monster movie.
Just because there's no need for it doesn't mean people want to see the 3D animated horrible things that are, you know.
But personally, I think that
Dr.
the...
Seuss style embodied in, what's it called? Modern technology, full
CGI.
Animated. All the horrible characterized.
I do think the Jim Carrey version is a little bit underrated. What Jim Carrey brought to the character and all that was really... It was a great collaboration of the two. I like little hints in the movie. Like, there's one moment in the movie where the Grinch, where he's still in his evil kind of phase, he's deciding what to do in the day, and he's like, save the world. You know, he has all these answers. So, like, in a way, of course, this isn't real and all that, but in that kind of lore, he's like a genius compared to the Whos of Whoville. He knows how to solve the world's problems, but he's so evil that he just decides not to. And I thought that was a brilliant little moment in the movie.
Yes.
So,
yeah, an underappreciated genius finds the true meaning of true meaning of Christmas.
There you go.
Finds the true meaning of being a genius. Finally.
I'm gonna have to go pretty soon, guys, and I'm gonna wish you guys a happy holidays, Merry Christmas, happy. And one thing before I go, Arthur.
Yes, sir.
You forgot you did three silly monster videos. Do you
That's
remember
right.
what the third one was?
I did three?
Yeah.
Really?
It's the third one. Cookie Monster. Remember?
Oh, yes. That was third. Yes. So the Grinch was the second one. Cool. Thanks for reminding me. There were three of them.
You seem to forget that one a lot. I gotta go, guys. It's
amazingly.
I have to get ready at the show.
Have
and
a good
I have to get ready to this
man.
Party. So okay. It's still a while off, but I have other stuff I have to do to get ready, so I
gotcha.
Can't stay for the full monster cast this time, unfortunately. But I will see you
guys
later.
Sorry.
Merry Christmas. Have a new year.
Hey, Gargamel.
All right, you all enjoy yourselves.
Enjoy
Gargamel, you have a happy new year and a Merry Christmas if you celebrate or not. You have a very
Gargamel.
Happy holiday if you celebrate or not. And a great time. It's been a pleasure having you this year and today.
I will. I'll see you later, guys.
See you
Bye.
Later. Dog Donzar, are you leaving too?
Yeah, it's 12 o'clock. I can't stay.
Alrighty. Before
so
our questions.
Yes.
Have a good night.
That's the beauty and the ugliness of this, guys. It's all international, but people are on different schedules. Well, thanks for joining, Dadanza, and sharing your information.
Not a problem. And seeing as I now learned that I can actually go and watch the videos that I missed, I'm very happy.
Right on. Alright. Let's go to... Actually, Z, did you want to say anything else on the Grinch?
He's green, he's mean, he's a gift-giving machine.
What is your answer to how he became what he is physically? Because there's no answer to it, but what is your answer?
Well if he became anything more than a normal Huvian, he probably was, what's it called?
Who?
He was probably a who before.
Right.
Going by the logic that he's not an entirely alien species and or just branch of what's it called? Hooven geneticism? I don't want to use that word. It sounds like he's in a complete different kind of life form.
Right.
But the thing is that we have nothing to indicate why he is why he's green. Could but just be the artistical rendering.
I have to... So a theory I just thought up is maybe he's green because his heart is so small. Now, at the end of the story, his heart became big. So does that mean that he's going to start shedding off this green fur and his skin tone's going to start turning more beige color like the other Whos?
I mean, maybe it's because of him. He grew all that all that fur due to the fact that he doesn't wear pants. You see how cold it is living
good
on
point.
A mountain.
Yeah, everybody else is dressed, right? And the Grinch is just happy and naked.
The Grinch's lack of pants has given us an incredible insight into the... No mind.
Nice. Over in our chat on YouTube, Tom Matrix said, Z, you should be a narrator for the next Grinch. He enjoys your voice. See, you got a good voice.
Ah, excellent. That's very pleasant to hear.
Alrighty. And let's see. Somebody asked, who is the person who has the Warframe? That's Jaden again. Warframe profile picture. Which one of you is that?
I am not fond of that game, so it is not me.
Let's see.
Does anybody?
No, that's a Mewtwo. That's a Pikachu. That's a Piccolo. Could it be me? Because I'm probably the closest thing to Warframe, even though I'm not a Warframe.
Right.
I'm
Necron. Okay.
I'm a Necron.
Thank you, Z, for sharing your moments. Did you share your memorable moment? I think you did already, right?
Yeah, I think I mentioned a few times about the fact that... Yeah, but that was the first time I tried to court a female into actually interacting with me on a daily basis without brutally trying to murder me.
Beautiful. We'll give you a moment here at the end to try to court a female again, okay?
All right.
Alrighty. Let's go on to Creative Equinox. He said, and I'll read this for him. He said, and by the way, Dande, if you can write out your Christmas monster and favorite moment, that would be great in the text here on Discord. And you as well, Piccolo. So Creative Equinox said, this is going to be cheesy, but honestly, every time I'm here, I love interacting with you guys. Wow, did you guys expect hearing that from Creative Equinox?
Well, my expectations for humanity is increasingly low, but I will not deny the fact that I'm pleasantly surprised to hear this.
I think Equinox's heart just grew 3 times bigger.
I mean, depending on his heart size and his heart rate and the kind of metamorphosis that happens when your heart grows, or any organ in general spontaneously gains 3 times its own mass.
Yeah.
That must be awfully painful.
Get a hospital ready for him. Okay, so he says...
I don't think a hospital is going to be able to cure... What's it called?
Joy?
joy is not a thing I want to cure. It's a thing I want to replicate, or spread, and or carry around like a infected bird. that does not make sense.
On the matter of favorite moments here on the Voices of the Monsterhood, Z said, my answer would be every time I wait for the crazy shenanigans of the next monster cast. And he does brilliantly wait for it. He doesn't just sit here or go somewhere. No, he's right here in Discord wreaking havoc and giving us a good time. Ooh, so we all appreciate Creative Equinox here. Let's see. My Christmas monster of choice, he says, would be my uncle that dressed up as Santa that one time when I was 4. Oh, is this a real picture then? We're not joking anymore here about the uncle. Now this is the real deal. I honestly can't remember his abilities since I blacked out after he entered the room. Okay, that's getting weird again. Also, can't personally ask him because he was sent to the electric chair back in 06. I'm assuming that's not his picture, truly. Plus, he doesn't look 4 in that picture anyway, so... Alrighty. So, Creative Equinox and his monstrous uncle again. Once again, moments with Creative Equinox's uncle, everybody. Moments with Equinox's uncle. Thanks for that, Equinox, I think. Let's go on to... And did he catch up anything? He's laughing at us. Great. Don't worry. I'll keep up the South African representation. The Grinch has gangrene. Gangrene. Dande, another person in our chat here, says, laters, happy holidays. Still waiting for story time with Z. We already had a little bit of a moment there. The music, the harp started playing. It was out of my control.
Is it just me, or does harps and me go very well along with one another?
Beautifully. Oh, we'll have to use that when recording as well. Let's see, how are we doing?
I mean, I would love to release a Christmas special of me reading the Grinch out. I mean, if there's support for it.
Hey, there is support. You're more than welcome to, Z. You know, maybe we should talk about a little bit of collaboration since you got the voice and I have the channel or something. Okay, let's move on to Dande. Dande says, Hans Trapp, and here's who he's talking about. Kind of looks like Krampus mixed with Lepaludi, who I was talking about. Not really. The anti-Santa.
I'm sorry, but Lepaludi, when I hear that word, I can't help but think of some kind of Swedish cooking.
Well, there you go. It's the cooking of human beings. Continuing here. So,
typical.
Hans Trapp is the anti-Santa.
Sorry.
He was a rich man who meddled in black magic. He'd dress up as a scarecrow and wear rags to lure in kids so he can eat them. Wow, so a rich guy that did black magic, he'd dress up as a scarecrow to get kids so he can eat them. It is, wow, that sounds pretty interesting, actually. Dande, can you let us know if this is a real person that did this?
I mean, if I found a real person that was dressed up in racked and tried to eat people, I think that would be a tramp and or very illegal doing things.
Yes. He kind of reminds me of Rasputin.
Rasputin, lover of the Russian.
No. Z.
We did have Bonnie M here.
Z, get with the program. Malcador, right hand of the emperor.
Yes. Chris, we cannot present that to people that do not know 40k. We cannot assume that every single person that listens to this knows what 40k is.
Also, as a side note regarding what I just sang, I wrote a song where I reworked the Rasputin song into 40k.
Nice.
It's beautiful. You should try to listen to it whenever it's done.
Cool.
And we'll find a person that is more suited towards the... What's it called? The singing. Because my singing voice is like... it's not that good.
So, Dande says that legend is based on a real-life person. So that's pretty interesting. I'd like to dig deeper into that, especially once I start doing episodes, if I ever do, about real life kind of monsters. Good one, Dande. Thanks for sharing that. And you guys just reminded me of one of my favorite moments in the Monster Cast too, which used to be how we couldn't avoid talking about Warhammer 40K. It just always got brought up, or Warhammer. And we've got a lot better with that over time, I noticed. But that used to be a funny little thing. So, by the way...
Theoretically, I am always talking about Warhammer, but I mostly talk about Necrons, but that's kind of my gimmick. It's the kind of thing when you pull the lever in my back that I'll start talking about Necrons.
Shout out to Necron Girl. All right, TMH Piccolo has a good one for us. TMH Piccolo says, okay, I'm ready, and I'm going to talk about the Strigel. These shaggy horned beasts get their kicks by stealing from naughty children and occasionally tearing them to pieces. It's said that you can avoid their wrath by leaving out some food so that they'll feast on leftovers rather than your offspring. I'm a good Namekian, and I did my homework. Beautiful. So leave out some food.
My homework is rather lackluster at times.
I would say to stay the safest during this time of year or any, leave out a bunch of food at your doorstep. Whatever you can afford to leave. If you have cans, make sure you open the cans. Make a specific kind of porridge. So that no strange beings come
sugar,
and bother
cinnamon,
you.
And what's it called? And butter. A good amount of butter.
Butter. We need butter. Now, Dande also said here, he said his favorite moments on these podcasts has been a bit hard. I guess meeting all you guys would be one. I agree. and it's a great place to be. The other would be when Arthur confused where my location was, even when I told him some time ago. Right. Dande's our South African friend, right? No. I got it now. I'm still messing up a Preachy Minx location now. But he's actually in the U.S. For some reason, I like to imagine all of you guys in South Africa, because I was just excited to meet people from there again in my life. But no, he's in the U.S., and I'm sure of that now, Dande. You will not be forgotten. Let's see. Don't worry. It was an image. I look. Google. Minibo. Okay, so just catching up here. All right. Creative Equinox wants someone to mention Russia. My favorite moment in MonsterCast was when I joined the great server. You're all cool people. All right, so shout out to the MonsterCast. Again, if anybody wants to join us here on the MonsterCast or just in Discord, the link is right there. You just click it and you join this community kind of website. It's pretty cool. I was new to it. I've been here about 5 months or something. We've been doing these monster casts for, I think, 3 months or 4 months. They just started up naturally. So that this is our Christmas special. We talked about our favorite monsters, our favorite, not favorite monsters, but Christmas or winter solstice monsters, and then our favorite moments on these Voices of the Monsterhood podcasts. We are in about an hour right now. I would like to ask this question to everybody, and you guys in the chat, on YouTube, and everywhere that you guys are watching, do answer yes or no. I just want yes or no answers, okay? So okay. The question is, are gremlins, and Raincrawler actually asked this first, but I was planning to ask this, so it was mutual. Are gremlins Christmas monsters? Let's start with Chris.
No.
Okay. Dande. Z.
I will say no too, if not for the simple fact that just because they are in a Christmas movie doesn't mean they are related to Christmas.
Good answer, okay. And Creative Equinox says maybe. Dande says no. And Piccolo is typing. He says yes. So I think most people say no. But we can all agree that the first Gremlins movie, or all of them, are Christmas movies. We can consider them Christmas movies. Although they're not Christmas monsters. But remember, those monsters were... I don't think they existed. We do have Gremlins in lore, I believe, in mythology. But the movie ones, I mean, they started with that movie. I don't think there's a story beforehand explaining their lore. So with that movie, kind of, they are a little bit Christmas-ish. We got another picture here. Who drew that? Nice work, Dande. I like Dande's style here.
And Dande makes good stuff.
Yeah, he does. It's Creative Equinox's desire for Mew titties. And I'm sure he's glad to hear that I said that live. Continuing. Now, let's see. What else do we have here? What do people say in the chat here? Jaden said, yeah. I don't date girls anymore. They are drama. Witches and female subjects. Let's see. Anti-Santa. What is Warhammer? No, in my opinion, Raincrawler says. Okay, so most people think that gremlins are not. Now, what is your favorite, let's see, winter type of monster movie? Anybody? We have Nightmare Before Christmas, Grinch, Yeti movies.
Favorite Christmas movie would definitely be Nightmare Before Christmas.
Now,
I do not remember, but that I think Die Hard is definitely going on my list for
but not,
Christmas movies.
Yeah, that's Christmas, but not Monster Christmas. Aha.
Oh, right. Monstrous Christmas movies. Monstrous Christmas movie. Does Doctor Who's Christmas specials count?
Sure. They'll count here. They're long enough.
The snowman, because
really, snowman. They had a snowman one. Nice.
They had several snowmen that was, what's it called? More along the lines of fort controlled snow. When you fought them, they were created.
Yes, hey, they do, honest, Creative
the
Equinox.
I really love that episode, must be Strax, but that's an entirely different aspect.
Welcome to the chat, Phonix. Well, Tom said Seventh Voyage of Sinbad, the Cyclops. He's just throwing that in there. He's been a fan of that, and he's been waiting for me to do a video patiently for over 3 years now. Thank you, Tom, for sticking with me, whether I made the video or not. Awesome monster, awesome movie.
Let's see.
Now let's see here. Phonix, if you like, go ahead and write out a Christmas monster you wanted to shout out this year. Dante said, I would say The Grinch with Boris Karloff. I like watching that the night before. Nightmare Before Christmas would be the second. Leprechaun's Christmas is another. Nice. Good shout outs here. Has a banshee in it. Ooh, and leprechauns. Really? I haven't seen that one. Awesome. I'll check it out. Another question to you guys. Are you ready? It is whether you consider Nightmare Before Christmas more of a Halloween movie or more of a Christmas movie. Deep
thoughts.
I watch
it on both for holidays. It is equal. It is balanced.
It is balanced,
he
says.
It is superior.
What do you think, Z?
Equal, balanced, superior.
4 years, Tom says. So long. It feels like only one. Nah, it does kind of feel... Okay, never mind. Z, what say you? Do you think Nightmare Before Christmas is more of a Christmas movie or more of a Halloween movie?
Does it have Santa Claus?
Yes.
Yes, it has Santa Claus. It's a Christmas movie.
Aww.
It's about Christmas.
It's such a beautiful movie.
Halloween and skeletons.
Yep, and the boogeyman. It's such a... Jaden says Halloween movie. It's such a...
That movie does not have...
Polar Express. That's interesting movie too. What's that? I think.
Is there something that movie does not have?
Not much. It does. It even has a werewolf, has a vampire. I love their little werewolf in that movie too. It's such a great movie, Nightmare Before Christmas, because of a few reasons. It combines those two holidays. It combines that period between Halloween and the end of the year. You know, that everything gets wild in the market and such, but it nicely, like, fits in anywhere through that season beautifully. And then the second thing is the music, the song. The song is the greatest Halloween song probably out there, and it's just because of the movie. It's sad because our Halloween music sucks. There's not much out there. Look how much Christmas music there is out there. Annoying Christmas music too, because there are some good ones that are kind of older songs that are kind of ancient and they have a good vibe to them. But how many?
I found the perfect songs. The most beautiful of all Christmas songs that you'll have to listen to all the time.
What?
I posted it.
You posted it. No, I don't want to click it. It already looks annoying. It's got an underage person with a guitar. Feliz Navidad. Actually, Feliz Navidad isn't too bad. I was surprised to hear it as much as I did in Vietnam. But anyway, shout out. I need people
Vietnam
to create...
Flashbacks.
Yeah. I want a shout out for people and the musicians out there. Create some more Halloween music. We need some good Halloween songs. Because right now, Nightmare Before Christmas theme is way ahead. And that's an awesome song. I think we can all agree on that.
Well, it's not just the Nightmare Before Christmas theme. We also have the Jack's Lament is a great Halloween song. We have Something's Up with Jack. which I am aware, painfully aware, is two more songs from The Nightmare Before Christmas, but like, it's the best.
Which song?
I mean, I think This Is Halloween do deserve its own place in Halloween. I mean, it's literally the defining
Halloween Hall of Fame. Phonix says that he doesn't celebrate Christmas. He's a Muslim already. I don't celebrate Christmas really literally either. I do more celebrate this time of year and season and the winter solstice, which was kind of the original happening of this time of year a long time ago until religion found it convenient to adopt it. But you're so welcome here, Phonix. So if you have any monster you want to mention of this time of year, you're more than welcome to, especially in your religion.
So, Arthur, are you Wiccan then?
Probably closer than the other things, but not completely either. No.
Yeah, I'm just a hard-born atheist. I find religion as a concept to be outdated, but I'm not going to miss an excuse to rest at home and not have to go to work.
Sure. I consider myself, in the broadest term, I guess, a mystic, a student of life, because too many words here, too many labels have too much indoctrination to it and feelings and thoughts behind it. So if I say that, it keeps me in the shadows and the blurriness of ambiguity, which is just fine with me, especially being one of the voices here. Go ahead, Z.
I forgot what I wanted to say.
Never mind. All this talk. See, Z, that's what happens. Either you blurt it out or you just forget it. You need to start typing.
I still can't get over the drawing of me that looks like a goblin. That's absolutely hilarious.
It is. It is beautiful.
Tom says Nightmare Before Christmas is perfect movie to watch on Thanksgiving family, which get-togethers. I agree. There's not many good Thanksgiving movies out there, and I can't think of any Thanksgiving monster movie. There's probably some crazy one with a killer turkey. I'm guessing a low-budget flick. My favorite Thanksgiving movie, we're kind of off topic here, but by far is Planes, Trains, and Automobiles. I absolutely love that movie. Gives me the feels. If you haven't seen it, you have to see it, with John Candy, long past, awesome guy. Planes, Trains, and Automobiles. Come on, guys. Steve Martin, all that. Shout out to anybody.
I will see if I'm able to watch it.
Awesome. You should.
So, since we're rounding up, mm-hmm. I'd like to make a suggestion for next week's Monster Cast.
Yes, yes.
If you say New Year's monsters, I'm going to twist your... Never mind.
It is in that same spirit, you know, New Year's, a brand new time. We're moving forward in time. The future is coming now. So, monsters that appear in modern day but have come from the future.
Future monsters?
Monsters that monsters come
from the future.
Okay,
yeah, from the future. Have come from the future. Schwarzenegger by now.
Gotcha.
Oh, sorry.
And by that, I don't mean like advanced aliens or but yeah, the Terminators would be. It's a monster that existed in the future.
That's a hard one. Here. That's a hard one. I like it because it's so narrow. Thank you, Chris, for making the narrow topic. I like that because usually we have too much to talk about, so we feel like 2 hours. I'd like to hit upon something where everybody just has nothing to say. It'd be interesting.
It's not some. Not advanced monster, like it just because mm-hmm. it's from space and its species has developed many futuristic stuff. From our standpoint in time, this is a thing that has come to us from the future in some kind of way. That kind of monster, as how the New Year comes upon us from the future, essentially.
Sure. Okay. So that's one of the ideas for our next Monster Cast, which will be next Saturday. For you people out there. You can always join those on Twitch and watch them afterward on Twitch. They will be on there. They won't get deleted. So we might have monsters from the future. Anybody else have any suggestions? Are we good with that one?
I think that's a good one. I really don't know what to say other than Arnold is going to be a hot topic next week.
By the way, Z, Great accent, but you said his name wrong. It's Arnold.
I mean, I,
Arnold.
I don't want to sound like that. It's just...
I would risk saying his last name, but at this particular point in time, I'm not sure that YouTube wouldn't do something to your channel if his last name was mentioned.
Test your English and German.
It's German. It shouldn't be, I mean...
Arnold. You gotta put some phlegm into it, too.
Just say Arnold's last name in your mind. And just dissect the name into words. You'll get what I mean.
I know what it means. I know.
Arnold
is
my childhood hero.
It's an incredibly beautiful name in its own most macabre way.
Hey, right on, Creative Equinox. He's got dibs on T-1000, by the way, guys. Apparently.
Arnold.
Shout out to Arnold. Creative Equinox says he was his childhood hero. Beside the bad things Arnold has done or anything, he's still quite the human being out there, and anybody should be able to realize that with what he's accomplished and such.
What bad things has Arnold done? I'm not aware of this information.
Oh, you know, making a child with his housekeeper instead of with the wife, you know, which... People have been waiting to see, you know, Arnold's son. What is he going to be like? And finally, it's a son due to his housekeeper. and other things. But nonetheless, he's still a great human being. He's accomplished so much. And there's a lot of cool people out there. Okay, guys. So next time we're going to talk about monsters from the future. Oh, and I need to shout out a monster that we didn't mention, and I wanted to. I'm glad we covered the Grinch, but I want to mention this one that people forget to mention for Christmas monsters or winter solstice monsters, and that, well, more Christmas, this one, and that is the ghost of Christmas future, past, and present.
Those classify as monsters.
Absolutely.
That is true.
I forgot Scrooge existed.
Oh, yeah,
sorry.
Scrooge.
Thinking of Scrooge McDuck.
Right, McDuck. I always forget about Scrooge for some reason. And you gotta see, if you guys haven't seen a good Scrooge movie, I'd recommend the one with Bill Murray. That's a pretty awesome Scrooge movie, and he's got a whole... What's that?
I am honestly ashamed of myself that I didn't think of the Three Christmas Ghosts, because literally yesterday I watched
Ghostbusters?
No. Overly Simplified Productions Christmas Special on A Christmas Carol. Also, shout outs to Overly Simplified Productions. It's glorious.
Yeah. So... Anyway, I wanted to shout that out. The cool moment that I like in the movie too is the moment of realization. And this speaks to me on different levels. If you guys research psychology or spirituality or self-help of some sort, where you try to open your awareness up or be a little bit enlightened or more positive, maybe you've been depressed. I think Scrooge shows that really well, because Bill Murray, in a sense, is a depressed type of person in the movie, and the
Grinch.
The ghosts kind of show him the reality and really broaden his vision and understanding of this reality. I know I'm talking a little deeper about it here, but that's what it signifies for me more. And it's always beautiful to see somebody wake up in that moment where they wake up and they see everything clearly. I know it's happened to me. It's happened to me earlier than a lot of people I've talked to. If it ever happens in your life, you will know, because you will feel like you're reborn. And it is psychological. It could be further spiritual if you want. Depends on your beliefs, but it's nonetheless a unforgettable moment in your life. So,
yes.
On that matter,
spiritual awakenings.
We're going on to Z, because Z has a lot of feelings. Yep. He has a lot of things to say.
I say a lot of things. I'm sorry.
So, Z, this is your moment to court. You have listeners out there. We're on YouTube. You are a Necron freak. You are half metallic yourself now. You are transforming your body into full metal. You are looking for a female
yes.
that enjoys the like. please tell us, please court Z, right in public. It's your moment.
All right, I should have prepared something for this.
Heard that smirkiness.
You have my email address. You have my email address, right?
Yes, everybody has email addresses.
Excellent. Add me on Discord and ask me about that and tell me how you feel deep from within your cold, empty heart or other things that are filled inside it. Not blood. I don't actually want blood. I mean, that's usually a logical thing that are inside of hearts. It's pop blood, but no mind. I'm getting way into this.
Okay. What kind of hobbies must she have?
I don't know. It must be something that is open to new things. Open to weird, very single, narrow-minded things, such as myself.
Beautiful. Yeah. Alrighty, so any last notes you want to send to all the ladies out there?
And all the boys, because everyone is equal in this world.
Right, right. But we're talking about your courtship now. Let's not get swayed.
Girls, females, have a good time. Good Christmas. Enjoy your time and try not to eat too much. You'll regret it. I regret eating too much. I can't stand up.
And that is how he gets the ladies.
I'll wake up the next morning and realize, why did I eat so much? I can't eat breakfast now.
By the way, hail, Louie. All right, see, so I guess that was your moment of courtship. Let's see if you get anything on the hook.
I should have brought a hook. That would have been a lot easier.
Nice. Tom Matrick, by the way, CG. Said his favorite Grinch or Scrooge version was the one with Patrick Stewart. Sorry, Chris, go ahead.
My favorite Grinch. My favorite one with Christmas Carol must be the one with Disney and actual Scrooge McDuck.
Z, to bring it back to the... Do you mean to tell us that you want to become a hooker?
I'm getting...
Essentially.
I'm getting my bat. I'm getting the bat, Chris. You deserve the bat.
Z.
I'm a rat. I should run away.
Z, Creative yes. Equinox asked, what's your favorite brand of oil? Come on. Favorite brand of oil.
You know, it's homemade. You know, just put it into the ground, wait a few billion years, and then it's done.
Beautiful.
You'll have it yourself. Homemade.
By the way, Dante made a good point here. Watermelon for that. He said, when Dr. Seuss wrote The Grinch, he was actually a Grinch for Christmas. Until he realized what he was doing. So he was acting the part. So again, when Dr. Seuss wrote that story, it's because of a realization that hit him mentally as well. So that's a pretty cool note. I didn't know that. And Dr. Seuss wrote amazing things. So we all appreciate that. He created the Grinch. So really cool. So it's all about that realization. And I know I mentioned that, guys, that moment that enlightenment hits you, but... One thing I've noticed, too, it can hit you numerous times throughout life, but I've never seen or heard it or felt it hit as hard as that one particular time. But anyway, on that note, I think we are ending here. Our next Monster Cast will be on Monsters from the Future. So please join us in that one. I hope you guys enjoyed this Monster Cast. It's been a beautiful ride. We wish you happy holidays out there. If you don't celebrate, then happy this time of the year as we near the end of the year. Happy New Year's, everybody. An early one as well for 2019. Let's see if we're going to have one more Monster Cast before the New Year. So we'll wish you guys that as well again. Any last words from our voices of the monsterhood?
Nice.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
I can now imagine an actual rat being chased by said goblin with a bat.
Already,
beautiful picture.
I'm not seeing
and
too much here.
In the meantime, the rat is flipping him off.
No worry, Louis Zenodog. Just glad to have you here. Thank you, Tom, for those emojis. I know we sync up, my man. All right, my friends. Thank you for joining this. I could ramble on. I'm not sure if people want to listen. I don't see that many watching. So if you do want us to ramble on, let us know immediately before I end this monster cast. Everybody set their final words. Something I wanted to mention, guys. I have had that on my mind strongly. I want to play something with you. I know, Chris, you were interested in Z. Maybe D&D or something on here, but maybe a board game. I might get a board game simulator for one of these. It's still on my mind.
I recommend Tabletop Simulator, or if you want it to be more of an RPG, Roll20.
Right. Okay. All right, guys. Until the next MonsterCast, Raincrawler asked, the next MonsterCast will appear. Oh, the next one on YouTube. Remember, they're all permanently up on Twitch, so you don't need an account on Twitch. You just go on there and you can watch. On YouTube, I don't know. I'm going to keep these limited. So any big holiday or something events, then we'll do them here. Otherwise, I'm not sure. This one was rather quick and sweet. This one of our quickest ones, actually. So, yeah. For the YouTube, I'm not sure. And yes, Louis, most people said that the gremlins are not to be considered Christmas monsters, but the movie to be considered a Christmas movie. All right, everybody say your goodbyes, and we will draw this MonsterCast number 15. Congratulations, guys. Oh, I'll talk the end of the year stuff later. Yeah, go ahead and say your last words and goodbyes, guys. That would be great.
Have a good time.
This has been I, Chris. A rat, bear, sometimes lion.
This has been the Chris Bot.
Have a good night. And happy Christmas.
Happy Hanukkah. Happy whatever.
Rebel against tradition, Z.
There you go.
Have a,
better yet, create your own traditions.
Christmas. But Christmas is a tradition. Monsters are traditions too, man. Can we have a monster tradition?
We already do.
Yes, every Saturday.
Fun fact, Christmas is my name day, so I get to celebrate two holidays at the same time.
Oh, congratulations.
Oh, that's your name day? Nice. I forgot what my name day is. We need name day in the US. Why not? Goodbye, everybody. Thanks for watching, listening, participating. Alrighty, my cam's off. And we'll be stopping the stream in 3, 2, 1.